heard on the radio the other day that the car company is scrambling to find a new big thing for families. And the way it was portrayed, I forget the name of the guy that does it on I-50.
Gilbert, his name, I can't remember. Anyway, he was saying that the baby boomers, their parents had the station wagon, and they grew up in the station wagon, but when they became parents, they didn't want the station wagon. They didn't want to be like their parents. So they got a minivan. And then my generation, I think it's Generation X, grew up in a minivan. But now that we're parents, we don't want the same thing that our parents grew up us around in. We want something different. So we got crossovers. And then they say that this generation, when they get older, they're going to not want crossovers, they're going to want something else. So the car companies are scrambling to find what the next best thing is going to be. All because, according to the way this man portrayed everything in this broadcast, all because they just don't want to have the same thing their parents did. They want to be a little bit different. They don't want to do it the exact same way. Sometimes I can see this with my own kids. I might tell them, you should try doing it this way. Ooh, we'll do it this way. Why do you do it that way? Because I want to do it that way. Or is it because I told you to do it one way, you just want to do it differently? I think I may have done that once or twice, maybe when I was younger. Probably a few more times than that. But sometimes in our society, we value doing something different for the sake of doing something different. Without always thinking about why we're doing what we're doing. Just do something different than what was before. The Lord in this gospel lesson asks us to do something very important. For first, seek the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And his righteousness is what I want to focus on today. And what is the righteousness of God? The righteousness of God is to do that which is holy, to do that which is godly. It's not to do everything else that we see going on outside. It's to do the things that are morally correct, to do the things beyond which is morally, that which is morally correct, and the things that God wants us to do, the things that are godly, the things that are divine. These things are the things that are holy and separate us from earthly things. That's what it means to seek his righteousness. And seeking his righteousness is not a static thing. That doesn't mean we're looking for a righteous God. We already know who the righteous God is. Instead, our goal is to act like that righteous God. It's to become like that righteous God. To do the things that are godly, not to do the things that are so common, not to do the things that are of this world. These are the things the Lord is asking us to do. And that means we have to think all the time about what we're doing. And not always rush to do things that are simply different from what has been done. Sometimes that's necessary. Sometimes we have to do things that are different than what we were taught, because sometimes we weren't taught the right things. But being different for the sake of being different is meaningless. Being different because we seek to be holy. Being different because we seek to be righteous. Being different because we seek to imitate God. Now that's a reason to change. That's a reason to be different. That's a reason to try something new. And this is what the Lord is telling us today.
I always laugh. I've mentioned before that so often our culture asks us to be different, be rebels, be go against the current, and all these different things that they're constantly telling us to do. It's wonderful mass marketing where everyone is supposed to be different and buy one thing or follow one trend or whatever it might be. We're called to something higher. Called to something special, and we're called to see the righteousness of God. We're called to act with holiness, to act in a godly manner in everything that we do. That alone separates us from the things of the world. That alone is what brings people into the faith. That alone marks us as Christians, by doing the things that are holy, by doing the things that God wants us to do. Not for the sake of just doing something different, but because there's a reason behind it, and that reason is that this is the way God wants us to live. Because that way of living is good. That way of living is wholesome. That way of living leads to other blessings and gifts throughout our lives. Message that we're given from our Lord. He's asking us to be different, but to be different according to His design, so that we become holy like Him.